knock the what? You can't knock the what? You can't knock the what? You can't knock the what? We the ones you despise, see it all in your eyes. We ain't never took a...
Can't Knock the Pod, episode 152.
Yeah.
We gave up on on said Spanish.
Uno, cinco, dos.
That's not it.
Wow, that was terrible. Can't Knock the Pod, episode 152, that's powered crazy. By LVH Studios. You have me, your host, Art Ward. To the right of me, welcome back.
Yeah, I'm back. Mr. Magic City.
We're trying to do better, so Stu.
That's great.
Welcome back,
Jeff. I appreciate it. Thanks for filling in, Stu.
Yeah, we appreciate you, bro. Internationally known on the ones
he
and
don't
twos.
Mean that.
I was with Stu this weekend, so I do. DJ Chet Banks.
Yeah.
Across from me, I got the hostess with the mostest.
Yeah.
The mother.
Uh-huh.
Lisette Alina.
What's poppin'? What's good?
To the left of Lisette. Also across from me. Big Cuddy.
Big Cuddy, not the little one.
Fee-fi-fo-fum.
Fuck off.
I've been stumping in my Air Force Ones.
I have Chucks on.
My Chucks.
Shout out to the Taylors.
I walked 2.5 miles
Shaq
with Chucks
Renee.
On.
That's crazy. Listen,
the laughter I got watching Shaq and Lissette walk across the street.
Oh my god!
It was like my side was hurting.
It was too far.
When they got to my car, they was like, "What the fuck is you laughing for?" Because they knew I was laughing at them. They knew already. Like it was not 2 miles.
It was at least 2.5 miles.
Well, street closure, man.
And then Quila goes to the grass. Like that's not legal.
Yeah, because if you thought I was walking to the corner then cutting down, you thought wrong.
Yeah, I would have jaywalked.
That's hilarious.
I jayed the hell out of that wall.
Then we almost got hit.
She almost got hit. I saved her life.
I did see that. You really like grabbed her back. Like,
no,
hey,
like, yo, chill. I really like tackled her. Like,
nah, you know how mad
even,
I
wasn't even like that.
You know how mad I'd have been if we couldn't record because you got hit by a car.
Man.
We would have got paid.
No, we wouldn't have.
For jaywalking?
No, I could have said like a or something like that. Oh, and I fell in the street or something.
What?
Like,
no.
I could have acted like, you know, it was an accident.
You wasn't going to leave.
These cameras down here.
I'll tell you what.
You talking about a check. You wasn't going to be here.
No, I was going to be here. God love me.
Beatrice wasn't taking that case.
Nah.
Beatrice was going to be
hey,
like,
dog.
You know,
Beatrice chased me anyway. He might have took it.
He was going to take the retainer money. And okay. Ass. Yeah.
Also in the building, we have on the cameras, Miss Brown Sugar.
Brown Sugar.
Miss Yo What's Crash up? Mar in the building.
How's
hey,
it going, Mar?
Also in the building, we got my man, Say It Ain't So, Fireman Designs. So. My boy Joe in the building. How's everybody doing?
Joe, yeah.
Beautiful.
It's
beautiful.
Say it ain't so, Joe.
Say it ain't so, Joe. Do want to give a shout out for Stu for holding it down last week.
Yeah, man.
In your absence.
Shout out to Down the Hill, man.
Right. It was, you know.
It was
I was listening to it on my way back.
Yeah.
Listen, I ain't going to hold you. When he just blurted out, yeah, my dad got 24 kids. I was like, Lord have mercy.
I was
just pulled out of an Arby's parking lot when that part came over.
It was like that thing where like a little kid yell out something he ain't supposed to yell out.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
My mama be hitting my dad. I'm like, God damn. Like,
for real.
Okay. It was like one of them. But yeah, shout out. He's been texting me ever since.
Man.
So for all y'all that text through, he did good. Thank you. I've been getting the screenshots, which is followed by, because Stu don't write out text messages.
He sends voice memos.
He sends voice memos.
He so sends voice memos,
he
man.
Send me the screenshot and then proceeds to send me a voice memo every time. Like, it's literally three that I haven't listened to.
Man.
But I didn't talk to him, but I just haven't played the messages because I know it's something about, yeah, man, I ain't fucking with you no more, man.
He said he got a deal on the way.
Yeah, BET calling me, man. They trying to get me. So thank y'all for pumping me up. Somebody said that he made the show.
Wow, the audacity.
I'm gonna read one.
He blocked the name out?
No, I got the name in this.
You got the name? Oh.
The name, whoever Carl is with a K.
Hey, you Carl. Know Carl.
That's somebody made up. That's his work phone. He's texting himself.
Yeah, he definitely
texts himself. Bro, if they don't make you a reoccurring guest host, they'd be crazy as hell. You made that episode. So shout out to Carl.
Shout out to Carl.
Well,
Carl,
tap like
in
that.
With some sponsor money, please.
Big money, Carl.
Carl a mess.
Carl got all the ideas.
Okay. Yeah, right, right.
Put some dollars behind them ideas.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Don't come for Carl.
I want to know who Carl is now.
Carl made the hell up. I'm going with that. Carl is made up. We just cussed out
he
a make-believe
person. He blocked out
person.
This one. He said, somebody said, you did your thing on the podcast. Three fist emojis.
Okay.
He probably said that to somebody. He said, hey, send this to me.
Yeah.
That's, like, no.
That's funny.
You did good.
Shout out to Stu, man.
I want to play a voice message from Stu.
Oh, yeah. Let's hear this.
Please
these voice messages
first.
Be a little wild.
I don't know what it's going to say, though.
They be playing Russian roulette with it.
It's okay.
Fuck it. Let's do it.
We playing Russian roulette. I have never listened to this one. This is after the one where they said make him a reoccurring guest. So first listen for all of us.
Oh,
if I have to stop it. I will.
Man.
All right, I'm famous now. Thank you, bro. I never forget you. I might even let you come shine my shoes some when I make some top.
All right, that wasn't bad.
Yeah, that wasn't that bad.
That wasn't that bad.
One more.
All right, well.
We pushing it.
I opened it. I like Russian roulette.
He said he might let you shine his shoes.
All right, here we go.
Yeah, when you're free. My phone about to die, though.
Oh, okay. Because I don't answer his calls.
Yep, I just listened to the last of it right now. I thought we were supposed to talk about my contract.
Oh. Okay,
you
here
were
we go.
Scared.
I was scared as fuck.
Man,
I was scared as fuck.
Yeah. All right, we'll go back.
I just listened to the last of it right now. I thought we were supposed to talk about my contract and my terms and conditions for when you need to fill me in for the future. Now, I apologize. I might let the Henny get to me a little bit, but I got the hang of this now. I don't want to not be on the show no more. I'm going to be quiet. I'm going to listen. I'm going to be good.
Man.
Lies. He's hilarious. Man, I cannot.
Scared, man. Okay, he got the lie down pat.
Mm-hmm.
he didn't mess up in the relationship before.
He was calling me and asking me, bro, is there somebody to do makeup before the show?
Man, that's hilarious, man.
Like, I almost canceled the whole show.
Man.
Right there. And he literally hasn't stopped calling me ever since he did it. So
hey, man, shout out to
he really
Steve,
enjoyed
man.
It, so shout out to Stu. I told him, he lucky I ain't know Keetuan was going to be in the city.
Oh, you?
Gave him the boot.
Keetuan would have came in representation.
Yeah, Keetuan would have been more of a representation of you.
I think my Southside brother did well, man. Y'all got the funniest relationship ever, man. Y'all professionally hate each other.
I literally don't like him. Love him to death at the same time. Joe understand.
Right. Right.
Let's just jump into this episode 152, powered by LVH Studios, and let's get right into that action. Let's not wait no more.
Let's not wait.
We canceling Cinco de Mayo.
Hey.
Oh, shit.
Love Sosa.
Why you look at me?
Shut down all the Taco Bells.
Oh, shit.
No more Taco Bell.
That's crazy. Talk heavy, big dog.
No.
None of that.
No El Cowboy.
No El Cowboy.
No El Jalapeno.
None of that. No more Berea.
Okay. No more
I love Berea.
Y'all wilding right now.
Listen, so.
Big Tank.
The Tank and Garcia fight was this weekend.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah.
So, a lot of people was picking Garcia.
Yeah.
I seen that slander. You fools.
And I
you fools.
You imbeciles.
I can't understand why, right?
You know what got him? They let him get that one little TikTok where he was doing the speed bag.
Right, right.
Fuck right. they whole and, like.
So this is how I knew the fight was going. You know, it was going to be like an easy fight. So I got my man Garcia come out first, right?
Man, that's when I knew he was going
to
lose.
This is where Garcia came out to.
Mm-mm.
Hold my hand.
Nah.
Spirit lead me where my trust is without borders.
Your pastor failed you, big dog. He told you this was cool.
This song is a banger, though.
Nah, hell no.
It ain't. It's like 8 minutes long.
It's a beautiful song.
This part is beautiful.
Nah, this is a nice song. But now when I'm about to bang.
Yeah, I feel like
you know what this
wedding.
Song is? This song is at the end of Fast and Furious.
Is it?
And Vin Diesel talking about the family. Yeah. How we come together. Like,
yeah. That's what this is for.
Yeah. Can't even stop it.
Come Once on, for God. Family, we're always family.
Yeah. That's
Nobody goes against the family.
Bad Boys for Life. Oh,
no, wrong movie.
Wrong movie.
Chat. This your second strike.
All right. I'm done. I'm
hey, Chip, say that again.
This your second strike. Nobody goes against the family. We eat together, we die together.
Fast and Furious 27.
Dominic is in the fucking nursing home. They fucking racing electric wheelchairs. Hey, God, man.
So you got my boy come out to that. And then. Man,
play with it. Play with Big Tank.
Hey, so then, listen.
Oh, man.
I'm at the thoughts. I'm like.
Hey.
Is that fucking Sosa? All it took was that bass line.
He turned up the volume.
I was like, oh.
Oh, man. Oh, I definitely. Oh. I demanded the remote. Cash went outside when this came out. Lord have mercy.
Hey,
man,
I told niggas right then and there, hey, it's get over. Your money back.
It's over with.
It's over.
I'm mad they cut Sosa mic off, though.
It's over.
It's over.
I ain't need the mic.
I ain't even care.
Him there was like an angel.
Bro,
he was like, he was in the ring.
Him
listen,
there.
Listen.
Sosa was like, you walk out with your pit bull, like.
Right. like, bruh, like, I couldn't believe he walked out to the other music, bro. Like, Garcia, like, what, baby boy, what you doing? Like, he young, I know that, but like, nah, bro. Could you imagine playing that?
No.
You about to fight.
It fits him, though. I can't.
Nah.
Yeah, he was just letting, you know, the ambience of the Lord consume
honest.
Him.
So what was out?
And allow him through his trials.
2002, I don't think I'm playing I Believe I Can Fly to go fight somebody at Wilson High School.
No.
Absolutely not.
Nah, I might have would have played Stump.
He would have had more points playing Stump.
He should have came out to Stump.
Yeah, or something from
Keep it gospel,
Mexico.
But still, like, you know.
Yeah, play something. Like, they would have respected him with, like, the mariachi sound. Like, they'd have been like, okay, he about to turn up.
He should have came out to a whole band.
Yeah,
a
whole mariachi band.
He ain't that type of Did y'all hear his?
Right. That's why he
sound like
faking.
An American.
Yeah.
He's Mexican-American.
Okay. But they've been riding that Mexican thing the whole fight.
Nigga said he talked better than Tank.
Oh, hey, listen. Tank from the trenches.
Listen.
Tell you right now.
The boy Tank from the sound bottom. Like, what's his name? Floyd.
I mean,
sound about tarted as Floyd. So.
Nah, but don't do that. Don't do that to Big Bruh. Don't do Big Bruh like that.
I'm going to get you a box.
Now, hey. This show's 2.5, Shaq.
Shaq.
You
now,
you skate on the dice.
Shaq, man.
They like you,
I'm
all,
be good.
But listen. Hey, we can't take too many more of them.
Okay.
God damn. Like,
let me
reel it in.
Yeah.
We're going to bleep her out, all right?
Dang. Look at Joe.
Oh, it's been real. Hey, stew you up.
Hey, we're going to bleep around. So what's up, L?
Wow. You know what? I ain't mad at that.
Come up off Shaq.
I ain't even mad at that because it's L. As long as it ain't stew.
Shaq, I mean, Seth will walk off the show.
Oh.
Man.
Going on strike.
Yeah, man, y'all funny for that. But no, Tank did everything right. Like,
listen, from he's start a phenomenal to finish, boxer, man.
He did everything right. He came out right. If you watch the fight, it seemed like Garcia was real, real aggressive.
Heck yeah.
It seemed like he wanted like show his dominance early, but he got caught slipping.
He was getting cocky too.
He was doing
He wasn't listening to his trainer.
He was doing the same exact thing, and Tank just timed it. He was like, punch, punch. You know what I'm saying? He was.
That's why, like, Garcia kind of got the first round, because that was kind of like, you ain't know that was coming. Yeah.
But this is the thing. With Tank, though, he lets you do that.
Yeah.
He learned from Floyd. Like,
because you're basically giving it away in that moment. You're like, oh, you going to keep doing this?
And
you
going to keep doing this? Like, okay. He stepped, like, man, you're going to keep.
Right,
you're
going to
keep doing the same combo. Bruh,
if you go back and watch that punch that knocked him down in the second round, the nigga Tank smiled. Before he threw the punch, because he like, I know this nigga is not.
Like, I got to do it to you now. You're going to keep doing it.
That's crazy.
I give it up to Garcia, because I ain't getting back up.
Yeah, I didn't think he was going to last five.
He tried, but, you know, that liver shot is.
No. I'm talking about the goddamn.
Oh, the first knockout.
The knockdown.
That was goddamn like a car accident.
Yeah. And that his adjunaline was going
but
at that point.
If you
so
notice,
get right up.
He changed.
Oh,
it was a different. The different Garcia
timid.
After that.
He was timid. Like Tuan was showing me. He's like, you see how his shoulders is back now. Like he was more like.
He ain't throw a power punch again until the sixth round.
Nah, Tank is strong
as hell.
Tank is a knockout artist in that weight class.
And that's the difference between him and Mayweather.
Mayweather wasn't a knockout guy.
He going the distance with you. He gonna win the decision. It's gonna be a unanimous decision,
right?
Yeah.
Tank ended it early. He ain't trying to go. Cause he got that power. I don't know why so many niggas doubted him. I'm happy for him.
I'm disappointed in Cash though. Like Tank, you gotta think though, cause Tank is Mayweather. It's like a more of a Mayweather and like I'm trying to think who else. Somebody's strong, but he can go the distance too. Like he's strong and he can go to 12.
He wasn't even sweating in there. Not because old boy wasn't aggressive no more. Three guys.
Yeah, man.
That punch. I hope Tank realized that he can be Mayweather.
Mm-hmm.
I think this fight.
You know,
this fight. What they sold? What 21,000 tickets for it? You had the pay per views. I think that this is a strong testament of him being the new face because he doesn't have. He's not number one.
Right.
But he has the highest draw. Out of all the boxing right now.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
I wouldn't care. I mean, that belt shit is dead. Nobody knows.
I wouldn't give a fuck about that
fuck
belt.
Fuck that belt shit.
Because I'm getting more money to y'all and I ain't got no belt.
How many belts Tyson had? How many belts Evander Holyfield had? You know what I mean? We just know they legends.
Tyson didn't have no belt and was still selling. He just sold out the last amateur fight he did.
Right.
So, yeah, man. I enjoyed the fight. It took me back to the old days.
Yeah.
I was okay with it ending in the second round because I was like, I missed this feeling. Like, you remember being young watching Roy Jones Jr. knock out a nigga or Mike Tyson, you know what I mean, in the early rounds? It definitely just took me back to that. I will say, did y'all watch the fights before the main event?
Yes, a couple.
How was that?
I missed like the first one.
I seen the one right before they got knocked out. Yeah.
The nigga that got knocked out.
Yeah, that was bad.
That was terrible.
Oh boy,
but like
way
he
bigger
was, and he but he was older. Like he took the fight within 10 days, and
oh,
you're
did?
Clearly older. Yeah, he took the fight within 10 days. He's older, as hell.
He needed that check.
That was that.
I think he was. He do it.
I think he was 20-1 or 27-1 or some shit like that. But he was older.
Yeah, the other cat had
no
belt.
Stamina.
No, the other cat record wasn't as good. He didn't have that many fights either.
No, he only had
eight fights.
He was seven. He was 8-1 or 8-0, if I'm not mistaken.
He wildin'.
Yeah. Hey. Young Cuban dude.
Sleep.
No, I saw the knockout.
Sleep.
Crazy.
They should have called that.
They knew he was gonna get knocked out because Tank and Garcia was scheduled to walk out at 11.
Yep, and then it's so early.
That fight started after 10, so it was like no way this is gonna be over by 11. If they go the distance, you know what I mean? Right. It was like, no way. They knew.
They said like, that old man.
He should have just kept his record. And kept
I think
it
that was over what? Second, first round?
It was second round.
Second round? Could have been the first, for real, for real.
It yeah. almost was. He was stumbling. The round ending saved him.
That's what I'm saying.
He would have been down sooner.
That? Yeah, that's man, funny. That, I enjoyed the.
Next time, I'm betting on boxing. I love boxing. I don't know.
I'm a fan of boxing.
It's like
too.
That adrenaline. Like.
I'm definitely going to the next one.
The next.
I'm going to go to the next tank fight.
Yeah, that shit was. That shit was hype, man. I was supposed to talk to Keelan because he went.
Oh, yeah, they look like they had a ball.
I was supposed to get a recap, but I didn't even talk to him. So
yeah.
I ain't going to just call him on that.
They had good seats, too. They had pretty good seats.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good seats.
Any more for the fight? I can't even.
Shout out to Floyd. I just want to say shout out to Floyd.
And it's an ongoing thing with De La Hoya and Floyd.
Shout out to De La Hoya. I just
been like that.
I love seeing them. They got their flowers, but they also, like Floyd always say, like, I'm going to eat off boxing when I'm not here anymore. Like, I'm going to forever be able to eat off boxing. And I think that I love the business of Floyd Mayweather. Mm-hmm. I think he's doing a great job.
When you're great, you can do that.
That's a fact.
When you're the greatest of your sport,
you can do that forever.
Look at Jordan.
Look at him.
Right.
I don't know who the greatest of football, but.
Shit. Prime?
Where we at, huh? All right. This is going to be a real solo conversation.
Why?
Because I'm the only one that's seen it.
I mean.
And I've seen all the goddamn memes.
Right.
And I don't care. Like, I didn't care if y'all was. I didn't care what episode y'all was going to say y'all was on. We was talking about it.
Clearly.
That's fine. Because, we don't care.
Yeah, that's fine. Jeez. But y'all didn't see it. So,
I do
and this
see
is
it,
for
though.
The listeners, too. If y'all haven't seen, we talk about Snowfall. We about to talk about it. I ain't going to say it's a super spoiler alert. I'm sure if you got any social media,
it's
you've
already
seen
ruined.
The pictures of Franklin. So you know how it ends up.
Say it ain't so.
I just want to give a round of applause. What a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant show. Great, great acting.
Amazing acting.
From all the people involved in it. Franklin, Damson Idris, if I'm saying it right, Lori Harvey boyfriend. That man had me zoned out on that last episode. To see a character start as like a damn near a little boy, for real, like a young green. He was real super green. Didn't really know what was going on. Just trying to get some money to come up to the boss, being $73 million in the bank, you know, back in that day, damn near a billion. To losing it all, being a bum, walking down up and down the street, a drunk, getting evicted.
It's a typical hood story.
But the range of that was just like, wow. Like, you know what I mean? Like a lot of shows, they normally already the boss or...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like if you want to compare it to... It's always been
they show the rise like from when they already kind of started.
Yeah. I mean, before he wasn't selling nothing.
Yeah.
It wasn't like he was in the dope game. Like, I mean, he had his family, you know, aunt was.
Yeah, they took their time with that.
They did. They didn't rush it. And that's what I like about it.
Yeah.
You know, I've been doing watching a lot of interviews from the people involved with it, because that's just what I do when I get into a show. I got to know everything about it for some reason. So I did the same thing with this, and it was like, you know, when John Singleton died, it was like, what was going to be the show? You know, how was they going to continue? Because it was his baby, but he wasn't the only one, you know, that started it.
Right.
It was actually three people that was involved with starting the show. So yes, John had a real strong input on it. They also had a strong input on it. So that's why the show was able to continue. And what they said was the writers on the show, they was like, John never said no or anything. And he never
ain't,
even.
Ain't John your cousin? Yeah. John's singing to Joe's cousin.
You think I don't know that?
That's dope.
No, I just wanted to tell the listeners that.
Oh, I was going to get there. I
like
was
we,
actually
Oh, I'm sorry. We no, is popping cool. for real. Like, we got John Singleton cousin.
No, real life. Real life. And that's why I was on Joe. You can ask him. I was on Joe like, yo.
About coming today?
Not even coming today, but finishing the show.
Oh, okay.
Because they did a tribute to his uncle in the show. I mean, his cousin. And I wanted him to see it.
Yeah.
So I was like, bro, you gotta finish. And I just wanted him to see the acting in it. And just, you know, the full circle of it. So
yeah,
he did go ahead and watch that in the last day. What is it, Shaq? He watched it in the last, it was like two seasons in a day.
Did you? Damn.
At least like a day and a half.
Wow.
So
I'm starting it in 2 months. July.
Yeah, but I'm actually going to restart it and watch it over.
Yeah, the end of July, I'm
watching
start
it over. I don't know when.
You watch
but,
while you don't leave.
Yep. That's going to be our
that's
thing.
That's the type of time I need.
Yeah.
To watch this. It is. But I do like how they didn't rush it. It really showed a lot of different stories when you really think about it. It wasn't just about Franklin.
No.
You've seen the stories of a lot of different people in it. But I just want to commend that kid, man.
No, he's a hell of an actor.
I was really, like, zoned out. Like, and I actually felt bad for the nigga. And I'm like, this nigga is rich.
No, but I think so many people saw that in their families. Like, you know, like, I think all of us know somebody like that.
Yeah.
You know, like, I was just with my uncle. Like,
I mean, to that
he's
extreme.
He's not an alcoholic, but
that's what I'm gonna
the
say.
Rise
that's
and fall.
Yeah.
I mean.
But that fall right there was a different type of fall.
I mean, I seen that one before in my family, though.
I haven't seen one where a cat be like the kingpin. You know, I seen a cat that got money before, but like kingpin to go to nothing. And a lot of people got a lot of things to say about, like, who fault was it? You know, they say people turned their back on Franklin. I don't really think that. You know, I think the moral of the story was greed. But everybody got their own interpretation of it. But I felt like it was more greed than anything what led to his demise.
I can't wait to watch it.
Yeah, it's exciting, man. I've been TikTok out in that last, like, 15 minutes. I just go and watch that last 15 minutes.
That's crazy.
I probably watched it like 15 times. Like, just the last 15 minutes. Like, because he just take me. Him walking, looking like a bum, talking to his boy Leon.
Leon, yeah.
It's just a great scene, man. That's great.
What was that movie scene they said that was in there?
Boys
that
in
they
the
implemented.
Hood.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Boys in the Hood. So that's what I wanted them, Joe to see. They walked past the set of them doing Boys in the Hood. And John was sitting in the director's chair. So that was super dope, man. Sad that he couldn't see, you know, his creation coming to an end. But I think he did the first 3 or 4 seasons.
Wow.
Yeah, I wonder if he got other stuff that, you know, he's had, like, in the queue that they bring to life for him.
I'm sure. It's funny because this went out today. I seen the picture. I think it was D-Ray and Lauren London was supposed to play Jerome and the aunt.
Yeah, hell nah.
The aunt.
Really?
Louis, yeah. She was supposed to play.
I can't see it.
Lauren London was supposed to play Louis. So I'm glad that shit didn't work out.
Yeah, no.
Because the actor that played Jerome...
That man is talented.
Man, because he is nothing like that.
Absolutely. Did you see the skit with him and Ha Ha Davis?
Yeah. But I watch his interviews, though. I watch that cat.
He's an amazing interviewer. He's super, like, he going to be here if they keep, I hope they, like, let him get these roles.
Yeah. He
don't even got to do this same role. I think he can play anything.
Fuck.
Like, I had to follow him on IG and everything. Like, all right, huh?
He is the exact opposite of
night and day.
Like, night and day. Like, it ain't even close to Jerome. Like, that's what tripped me out. Like,
I see this post when he posted Franklin was like, Unc rolling over in his grave. But, like, I like that he, even in interviews, like, don't get mad at the fans for appreciating the character of Jerome. Because some people get mad or, like, you know, like, yo, I ain't on that today. Like, when people, I see people like tag him a lot, like even him in interviews, they be like, man, do it. He be like, I'm not in character today. And then like he start talking like he more pull the wig out or like, you know what I mean? It's like.
He did that with Matt Barnes.
I like that, he don't like be too full of it. So like, I ain't doing that today. Like,
I mean, you got to think like, I ain't gonna say I can understand, but like some of them actors that have been in a lot of different roles, they probably do get like, all right, man.
Listen.
But like, listen. This is like his Denzel first one.
Better keep Jack. Jack.
You think like, you think you could get Denzel to do that?
I think Denzel would do
hell
it.
Hell no.
You don't think Uncle do it?
Hell no. No, because
I see how he be interacting like. That I don't know. I might do it.
He might.
What's the mother?
Denzel is not gonna say Jank on cue for you niggas.
Man, he might, man.
He humble. I ain't trying to bust y'all bubble.
I think
first of all,
Denzel ain't doing it.
Now you know who ain't doing it.
Maybe not, but Big Cudi, he gonna put some respect on Big Cudi name.
Will Smith probably ain't doing none of his. He ain't doing it.
No.
Niggas ain't gonna act Will. Martin, I don't think Martin. Martin probably ain't doing it either.
None of them big actors.
But
is
them
doing
niggas
that
don't
shit.
Be out. Denzel be outside.
He just seem more laid back.
He seem way more chill, and he seems a lot more
spiritual and humble. He ain't gonna be ignorant about the no.
Them other niggas gonna be ignorant.
But it is gonna be a no. It's gonna be like, ah, man, I'm not. No.
Hey, young fella, let me sign a hat for you, okay? Get the phone out of here.
He gonna say something like, "You gonna pay me to do that? Because they pay me to do that." You know, some shit like that, like. But nah, that's all I got for Snowfall.
Shout out to Snowfall, man.
Can't wait for you guys to watch show. It. Amazing show. I'm running it back.
That's how you know it's a good show.
And this leads me into white TV versus black TV. Okay? And I know what y'all thinking. You know, I don't know what y'all thinking. But I'm going to just let y'all know, I really, really like white TV way better than black TV. And it ain't because what they probably think. Y'all know why. And y'all, because y'all see why I'm saying this. But white TV, let's go over the pros.
No.
Go ahead.
He like TV shows that's not popular amongst black people.
Right.
Right. Them the best, and that's normally white TV. Black people don't watch white TV shows, but Grey's Anatomy.
That's my shit. Love that show.
They're not watching. You got your select. You got your few. You know, we got our community.
I cut somebody out.
I can watch it.
I ain't never seen a status about billions.
A black TV show that niggas like. You literally got, or the episode come on at 8.
You got overnight.
Yeah, you got to the next day.
Maybe.
You maybe, because it'd be that one ignorant person that just be like, bro, I can't believe they killed Big Boy.
Hey, you ever try to stop reading it?
Oh, it'd be,
but like you can't, like you just keep reading it.
Your brain messed you up. Like,
you'd be like, oh.
I didn't want to see that. Take it away, Lord.
It's people who watch it at 8 and posting by 9.
Like, I can't stand. I hope something happened to those type of people. I do not like that.
What he means
I
is, we
that.
Hope that you stub your pinky toe on one of the doorways in your house.
You're evil, and God ain't in that.
Mm-mm. Right? You ain't getting blessed.
Say that. No,
you is not covered.
You're not.
Mm-mm.
You what? I'm episodes back on Succession. Having a grand time on Facebook, like
they don't even know Succession exists.
Ain't no spoilers coming. You miss a week of Power, nigga. You,
oh my god,
you on your timeline like
tiptoeing,
like
you can't even really scroll on no social media, Instagram, nothing. They already got the clip up on the Shade Room. Yep. You can't even scroll.
They really killed this season finale of Snowfall.
Oh, man.
I feel like I saw it. Just
no, it wasn't instantly though, because I watched it the next day and had never seen it.
I was seeing the picture of him and I thought it was a different movie.
Yeah, me too.
I was
me
like,
too.
Oh, he in something else. This is about to be good.
Me too.
And then I'm like, oh,
right.
This is how it ended. I've never seen the show. And I'm telling you the character names and everything. Like, never watched one episode.
But don't that blow your shit? Like, think about it. Because you about to go start the series.
No, not if you wait. If you wait, You know what I'm saying? Yeah, if he wait like another month,
end of July,
he'll be cool.
I'm gonna be into it.
He,
you know,
he know the ending, but
yeah,
knowing the ending. I mean, of I know in between, like
I know Jerome got killed. I mean, like, yeah.
I like to be surprised.
Now that's what fucked me up. I was mad as fuck. That's what made me start watching it. Cause I was like, all right, I'm gonna wait on this last season.
Oh, when they started posting it,
and then it was like Jerome got killed. I was like, all right, now I gotta binge watch this.
Bitches,
you motherfuckers done ruined it. So the whole time I'm watching, I don't know what episode it is, man, but I know it's fucking coming. So
I'm thinking, I'm in a situation. Hey, yeah, about every to go little down. Thing,
I'm like, man, no, Romy, wrong,
man.
I'm like, nah, this is it. This is it. Ooh, another episode. We made it. Like,
that's silly, man.
But nah, man. It's just so much peace when you just watching.
Yeah, man.
A show that don't nobody watch.
I ain't never seen a status about.
And it's normally a white.
Whatever. Billions. I never seen one about Ozark. I love Ozark.
Like, that, a few.
No, it really wasn't no spoilers about Ozark. Nah. People would just say like Ozark good or something, but they wasn't really blowing it.
It wasn't blowing.
They only do that shit for black shows.
That's it.
What was that one?
Miss a week of BMF. I bet you know what Meech did.
That's for a sure. Fact. You
yeah, because they did not let that sex scene with him live, not even a little bit.
I mean, the internet kills me, man.
It's kind of.
But I ain't gonna worry
to
about that with Succession.
You don't.
I'm not. And the crazy thing is, I haven't started the new season, and I haven't seen anything about it.
About
I'm
what?
I'm waiting.
Hey, listen.
Succession.
When you watch it. You're going to be like, wow, I can't believe nobody said nothing about this.
I can't wait. Mm. I'm surprised. I think, honestly, my wife watched it and just going to watch it with me again because she does stuff like that.
That's the good wife.
No, that's crazy. Right.
That's some shit I would do.
She did that with me with Power. I didn't even know Power was out. She watched two seasons and didn't tell me.
Wow.
And I was like.
Quality.
And then she told me after we started the third season, I already watched these.
Hey, babe, what the fuck? Look here, listen.
Seth be doing that too.
That's not right.
Aunt told us.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, he did.
Aunt told
that
us.
That ain't right.
Doing. Now he do it to me.
I don't do that. I never did that. Like that's a code. Like you can't do that. Like you watch the episode.
It's like a code in a relationship, right?
Yeah, you can't. Don't do that.
That's what happened. That's why I haven't seen Snowfall because we started it together and then he left me.
Now don't get on here doing that.
Literally, listen, figuratively.
I'm not playing with you today. Now stop it.
Kudos to that man.
Yeah, God bless you
for protecting his peace.
Yeah.
Wow.
I will say I don't have that problem either, Shaq. I wish I had. You know what I'm saying? I want somebody to watch the show before me. Like, babe, why you do that?
I'd be mad. I was mad he watched the Snowfall finale. You be pissed for real. Like, it started fights.
No.
I just watch it when I want to. Like, I ain't. I want somebody to be mad.
Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness.
This guy's out of control, man. This is crazy. Yo, this guy is nuts, man.
Wow.
That's hilarious, man.
Yeah. Oh man.
Yo, funny, man. This guy is crazy, man.
That's funny. Let's get into our. So this is a new thing we doing. Did y'all got anything else about white TV versus black TV?
Mm-mm.
No. But hey, DM us new shows. Because I'm getting ready to go on the leave. I need something to watch.
I'm not taking their advice.
So send me. Nah. Some people might
You're
have
not taking
show.
One of their friends' advice? That's kind of like a shot to the gut, Art.
Yeah, friends.
Hey, big dog, I got you. Yeah. You don't need them. I got you.
The friends know.
Nah.
You don't know.
I don't trust the internet.
We ain't saying the internet.
Y'all motherfuckers
friends.
Told me Creed was good. I ain't over that.
I still ain't seen
Creed. You ain't over you picking that
Super Mario
seat.
Brothers was good,
know.
Though.
I want to watch it.
Yeah, go see Super Mario Brothers. It was
Creed
good.
Was just fast as fuck. I was mad about that.
What was?
Creed was fast. I ended up watching it this weekend.
It was
fast. I was mad. But I had to walk out on one part. Fuck
Whoa,
me up.
What? What?
It almost made me cry. I just had to walk out.
Creed?
Yeah.
You didn't like it, did you?
It was all right. I wish it could have been better. It's only two fight scenes.
From the hype. of what they try to,
yeah,
do
like
the people.
They should have had him fighting more that led up to him fighting Adonis. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was just like, oh, he punched him in the face at the beach. Now we're doing interviews about a fight. And we're here.
Yeah, that's what everybody keeps saying.
I did two punching bags and now I'm worldwide and I'm rich in this fucking mansion doing fucking chin-ups on some stairs that I just bought.
Wow. Y'all ain't want to believe me.
I was mad at that. Like,
y'all ain't believe me.
At least like three or four fights. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I loved the presentation, the Dazzin, the Showtime. I loved all that.
Dragged that black film.
Because it made me mad.
That's crazy.
It did. It made me so
put
mad.
Put that nigga ass in the dirt.
Man, chill out.
Smoking
man.
On Pukalote tonight.
Man. I tell you what.
They was trying to hurry up.
I tell you what.
They must have known that shit was going to be happening with old boy because they could have led that to a Creed
you
4
can tell
or 5.
Cinco de Mayo around the corner.
First of all, I ain't Mexican, Quila. Hey. I ain't gonna keep telling you this. It's been 13 years that we 14.
That's
how many
crazy.
Years? 16.
This supposed to be your best friend.
And,
she keep calling
and
you
I don't
Mexican.
Celebrate Cinco de Mayo. Chip asked me this last week.
Hey, I'm sorry. Listen.
Okay, I thought it was a Hispanic holiday.
It is a Mexican.
So I texted her. I was like, "Yo,
the world do not.
What
no
you got going on May 5th? I need some.
I may have an opportunity.
I said I may have an opportunity."
And I said, what's up?
We need some representation.
Oh, no, he said Cinco de Mayo. And I'm like, no, Chip, that's a Mexican holiday. He didn't even text me back.
I text all my Puerto Rican friends. Listen, one of my friends is waiting on me because y'all responded first. I DM'd him like, hey, send me your number, bro. I got something for you. And when y'all was like, we don't celebrate that, I ain't even text him. He texted me and said, like, bro, I'm excited. What's going on?
Oh my God.
If you hear this, big dog, I'm gonna hit you back.
And that nigga Chill was like, you know, they're doing the parade this year and they need some people. So what's up?
That's what that's why I was tapping in. Like, I needed like Spanish artists, like every, like I thought it was, you know, y'all both speak Spanish. I mean,
Lo siento, Chip. But
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You ain't like Creed 3 either, right?
No.
Like, the people that seen it in here didn't like
it. We ain't talking about Creed.
All right, I just want to make sure. Yeah, and I hope everything worked out with Jonathan, man. I don't know too much about it, but it's just,
it's looking bad.
Like,
people dropping him.
Yeah.
Left and right.
It's never a good thing, but I don't have too much info, so we're not going to talk about that. But I do want to get into our new thing that we're starting to do every week. Each week, we are going to have a featured business of the week. And this week, our featured business is... ladies, please help me on this one so I don't mispronounce. What you laughing at? I typed something wrong?
Basil's
Beauty.
Hold on,
wait.
No, because we ain't finna.
Oh, all right, I misspelled your.
We ain't finna do that. I don't really.
You see how that's all fucked up. So, all right, we starting over.
Okay.
All right, because we're gonna clip this up for the person. So,
start over.
We don't want to cuss in it, so
keep this on the podcast part, but you know, put this up in the YouTube
for sure.
Yeah,
but we all ready?
Okay, we're ready.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
smile, Cleela.
Yes, y'all.
Our featured business of the week, Bezos Beauty, located at 3616 Market Street inside Serenity Inc. Tattoo shop. It is a licensed cosmetic tattoo artist, she specializes in eyebrow.
My bro.
Micro shading, permanent lip blushing, and more. Shout out to Miss Jay Gonzalez, Jessica Gonzalez.
Shout out to Jay.
Her website is Bezos Beauty. That's Bezos Beauty.glossgenius.com.
Ooh, fancy.
Bezos Beauty.glossgenius.com. The phone number is 330-719-3381. Yeah, I'm looking at her website here right now. You can click the website so you can look at it too.
Bezos Beauty.
Shaq, you actually have used her services before, correct?
I have.
What have you?
Dope experience. Jay, super dope. I'm not being biased. Great work. And she actually cares about what she's doing. Like, she's real thorough.
Right.
And she was doing my lashes. She told me I need to give it a break. Like, she could have took my money and just did whatever, and they fall off in a week, and I wouldn't care. But yeah, that was, you know, that's just real dope. She's a dope person.
Jess was welcoming and knowledgeable. She has a great vibe and explained everything to me in detail, making the experience comfortable. I would trust her for all my permanent makeup needs. My eyebrows look amazing. I'm a fan of the eyebrow.
Yeah, testing. She got some dope reviews on her.
Yeah, she got some really nice reviews on her.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of the eyebrow thing. You like that? The permanent one? It's like, why wouldn't you get it permanent?
You paying for it? You like getting them to pay
it's
for it?
It's a tattoo, though, ain't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you never got to do your eyebrows again.
Maintenance, but.
I mean, not like y'all got to do. Like, y'all got to go get threaded every week or every other week or every 2 weeks.
Every four.
Is yours tatted on?
Just counting.
No. Oh,
you look good.
Mm-hmm. I get mine threaded.
Don't that thread hurt?
The thread does hurt like a bitch.
It does
hurt. Yeah, I hear the thread.
Yeah, I heard the thread hurt. I've been here before.
If it, I mean, it kind of feels good, but it does hurt.
After you got to put ice on it?
No. No.
And like bubble up right over here. No. Well, you ain't get it done in a while, bubble up. You look like a little snake.
It's a lot.
It's a little irritation.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm here for the eyebrow thing.
So I think I would love to try that lip. Like,
is the lip a tattoo?
I want to look like that.
It's not going to do that.
No. It looked like it right here.
It looked like it right here, though. The lip.
What is it going to do?
Because your lip is like swollen right after. But she can basically change the pigment.
Oh, she took the picture after the
swell. I love that.
Right after, huh?
Yeah.
That's okay, dope. So hers is swelled up.
That's dope. I like that. Shout out to Jay.
But somebody want their lips permanently red?
They do that now.
Yeah, surprisingly. Mm-hmm.
Like a hint of like a little pink, little pinkish.
But they still can wear a different color lipstick, right?
Yeah. It's just your natural lip. It just looks like you always have pink lips.
And listen, man.
So this is a tattoo right here.
The lip shading?
Yeah.
That it's a form. It's a form of it, right?
It's a tattoo.
Yeah. Wow.
Mm-hmm. That's dope.
Y'all mad at niggas for going to get longer knees and abs and shit.
Man.
Ain't nobody mad at that.
Okay. But shout out to Bezos Beauty. Make sure y'all check her out, man. I actually seen her start from nothing to where she is now, and it has been a beautiful journey just to watch it for real. Like, no lie. Like, I tell anybody that. I actually have told people her story. Like, I've actually seen her go from not ever doing that to learning how to do it,
yep,
to having a successful business and doing it, like, all within the last couple years. So shout out to Jay for that. And if you want to be featured in our business of the week, all you got to do is email us. Like, go to our social media. The post is there. Email us the information, and we'll feature you as a business of the week.
Yeah.
Tap in.
Tap in.
Tap in.
Tap in.
Where we at? Yeah, this is going to be a quick one. We'll be out of here pretty soon, guys. Music. Let's get into this, a little bit of music.
What is this?
You never heard, you don't know what this is?
Yeah, but it's like seeing it on paper. It's like, huh?
So it's this ratchet song going out, and it's been out. I've been wanting to talk about it for weeks, and I've just been forgetting. So I didn't forget this week. So I'm gonna play this song, and then we're gonna talk about it as a community.
As a community.
Take heat, fuck these niggas up. I'm out of town, thuggin' with my round. My coochie pink, my booty hole brown. Where the niggas? I'm looking for the hoes. Quit playing, nigga, cause suck a bitch soul. Pound town, just left pound town. Let my nigga, he just took a bitch down. Yeah, that nigga dick a bitch down. Yeah, that nigga eat me out. Pound town, just left pound town.
All
right. Let my nigga, he just took a bitch down.
Dick down.
Yeah, that nigga dick a bitch down. Yeah, that nigga eat me out. I'm out here in Miami, looking for the hoochie daddy.
Where they at?
Where the niggas that get ratchet?
Where they at? I'm trying to get my coochie scratched.
It's a bit much.
I listened to it twice today.
Nah, you was listening to it way before the day.
No.
Get the fuck out of here.
I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan.
You're a big fan.
No,
you
I'm not
just
a fan.
I'm joking over there. And I'm thinking what? Like, okay, the beat is a little catchy, so I get it. But
you never heard
you
it?
Are. No. I no. Oh,
you got a big dog? you good? Like, God damn.
I'm cracking up.
that her name is Sexy Red. The name of the song is called Pound Town. I stopped it for when she said my son need a new pappy. Not lucky. Too many bitches where the niggas at. I'm trying to get my coochie scratched. Oh,
God, okay, enough.
She repeats that twice. She trying to get it scratched.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that shit right there.
You know them dreadheads do it the best. That's what she said. I don't want to get it confused. Speaking of quotes. Yeah, that's somebody's like daughter,
mm-hmm.
sibling,
mm-hmm.
niece,
yep.
cousin,
yep.
neighbor,
mother,
and mother.
Yeah, it's a bit much.
It's
a bit
it's heavy.
Much.
It's heavy.
And it's being played. Like, she's getting booked.
She got 500,000 views on this song. And then the remix got like 1.1 million.
It's a remix?
They in Miami for Spring Break Edition.
Ass Who on the remix?
Ass is everywhere. No, it's just like a remix rendition of Spring Break with that song.
Oh, my goodness.
But Young Miami in her video, Lil Baby, Autumn.
No, I got to go see it.
It must have just been a QC party.
Is she a QC artist?
No, but she was where they were for show. They utilized the hell out of their footage. Yeah, it's the booty hole brown for me.
My pink booty hole brown.
It's a lot.
Pound Town.
Just mm-hmm. left Pound Town.
Dick a bitch down.
That's how she sounds. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, she said it all.
So
yeah.
No for me, dog. The beat fire, though.
The beat, because Tay Keith produced fucking songs for Beyonce.
Yeah.
Beat fire.
Yeah, I can't lie. I caught myself singing it. Just the beginning part, though. I'm out of town. Like, with my rap. I'm like,
go ahead.
Oh my
the
God.
Rest, you ain't stop right there.
I did stop.
Chip,
right
you
there.
Playing this in the club?
No.
Why Chip. You ain't playing this in the club? What is this what the people want?
Cuddy, this is what the people want.
This is what the people want. I'm not going.
I'm so mad.
You think they want to hear it?
Yes. The young
Ooh,
love.
Please try it.
Little
I mean, the beat. Honestly, you can play anything in the club.
The beat is fucking
like.
Fire.
I mean,
I almost
you can play anything
on this
in
shit.
The club, but this is a lot.
The little ratchets want it.
Listen,
they want to
bet.
Be outside.
I bet
outside.
Every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and
God
Sunday.
God forbid you
used to be.
You have you have the crib in your office. If your kid in there playing this, man. You probably fall.
They doing a TikTok to it. Just
you probably
pound
fall
pound.
Trying to run to the room. So no, bad.
You just leave the meeting.
Sorry, I have a connection issue.
Yeah, just like hit in and then send the IM. Like I don't know what's going on in my computer. Like I done been there. Trust me.
No, I'm saying not even. I'm just period. They listen to it. I don't care if you in a meeting. Or are you taking a nap? If I hear my
nah,
kids.
If I hear my kids, they get a drop
head,
kick
right?
to the throat.
Yeah.
They know better. TikTok. They hear it.
They're not
they
even
ain't going. Even got TikTok.
Oh,
I don't play. I don't play around.
I hate that I ever let my daughter
nope.
get on TikTok.
No TikTok. We got time limits
no,
on them tablets.
Kids too, way too young.
Yeah. Even when they get old, I don't know. This technology, because not to get off subject, but I'm noticing, like, they really trying to bait these kids in the. Like, my son asked us about strokes yesterday. Because he saw it was on a YouTube rabbit hole that he then went down. He was like, yeah, I was learning about strokes today. What are they?
Wait, what?
And we was like.
Breast strokes?
Like a, no, like the health stroke. Not those type of strokes.
Oh, God. Lord
have mercy.
Okay,
she thought
you
was over there talking about.
No.
Okay.
Deep
okay.
swimming, no. like.
But he also in the cologne now, though, because
no,
I caught him on his YouTube page.
Your horny ass.
What to do to get girls on his YouTube. Shoot. Yeah, it's too early.
I think that's a reliable search. It ain't. That's a reliable search.
It's coming, Cuddy.
What is Harrison 10th?
Nah.
Oh my God. It's around the corner.
He asked us for cologne for his birthday.
What grade is that?
Third.
It might be closer than you think.
It's definitely next grade. It's definitely
fourth grade. For sure. That's when I got him. Nah, I got him my first squabble at 6.
No, but I'm saying when I was watching that. I'm thinking of doing after school program when I would have 4 through 6.
They turned
what they'd be talking about, and I'd be like.
Third grade is when I first had my first crush, though. I remember Ashley.
Mine was in preschool.
Wow.
Third grade was when I was like, oh, I like her. Like, she's coming home with us. Oh, I was like, no, she's in. Like, you crazy. Like, she's in third grade.
Can we get back to brown booty hoes?
Okay. Yeah, sorry. Yeah.
No.
We got off topic. Next topic.
She's in brown booty hoes.
That's crazy.
Like, what? Where are we at here? Like, next topic is booty hoe brown.
He talking about. You're right. Okay. I don't know how. That's Chip's fault.
It is Chip's fault. I just wanted to say, is this where we at music wise for women?
It's no, terrible. Don't. No. Come on now. Don't do that.
No, we got new babe, Scarlett.
Don't do that.
What do y'all listen to women rap?
Yeah.
You listen to Cash Doll Mara. That's pretty.
And you do, don't be embarrassed.
All right. I got you on video because I'll put that motherfucker out.
You like Cash Doll.
I gotta see that.
You never seen her rap Cash Doll?
No.
Oh yeah. Shorter video.
It's coming to the group text.
Yeah.
It's coming to the group chat. I know who Seth listens to. Cardi B.
Seth listen to Cardi B.
Cardi, Lakia, Lotto, Lola.
Lotto is really the best.
I like Cash Doll.
I like Lotto the best. I ain't gonna say she is the best, but
who else? I
like Lotto.
I'm not even talking about her looks though.
What's the new little one? I forget her
name.
And
that one too.
Ice Spice. I like Ice Spice's new record with Nicki.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
She gonna be around.
Ice Spice is?
I think they trying to push Ice Spice.
Lil Keyu, I listen to her. She a New York rapper.
They trying to push Ice Spice because
they pushing her.
Colorism.
Oh, you think it's the light skin?
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Really?
You thought I was feeling you?
After that, it hasn't been nothing.
Nah,
else.
This new one. You don't I like did the like new the new one.
I mean, maybe the new goodness. One, but she didn't have about 4 or 5 of them that came out and just.
But the crazy thing is, and I told y'all this about Nicki, they're targeting kids with Ice Spice. The little girls. That shit is popping up everywhere.
They're trying to do with Coi Leray?
No, I think Coi Leray can be going to be here. I like Coi Leray.
No, I know. I'm saying, but she still kind of went after the TikTok kids, though.
Yeah. I think because her record, to me, I think she might have the biggest, highest Billboard single out of the women right now.
Who, Coi Leray?
Out of the new ones, yeah. Oh, that Players is in her last single.
You got to think, Coi Leray got... Oh, 5, 6 bangers out that you probably know without even really knowing.
Yeah, and she on every festival.
Being at the radio.
Yeah, she on every festival, so I don't know. We'll see.
I fuck with Coi Leray because she do her.
Yeah, she don't care. She not. And you got to think her dad been Zeno, so she been around this before.
And she had to deal with that bitch ass shit.
Yeah, she don't seem like she got a. She's not blinded by the limelight.
Cause remember, he was trying to, like, hate on her for some reason.
He talked about it in an interview. It didn't really explain it, but I kind of get what he was trying to say. He thinks she a fucking boy. Like, she's a girl. Like, chill out with the tough love.
Yeah, for real.
But they're cool based on what she said and he said in the interview.
You ready?
Ready for what?
Saturday.
No. Yeah, it's going to be, I want it to be a boy.
So by next week we'll know what we're gonna be.
Yeah, we're gonna know. Yeah.
So by next episode, we're gonna name it whatever it is.
Okay.
Like, it's a girl.
I think it's gonna be a boy.
It's a boy. It's a girl.
I might cry if it's a girl. All right, I can't do another.
You want me to bring a J for you just in case?
Yeah, bro. No.
Oh, my
goodness. I hope it's a boy though.
I want it to be whatever you want it to be.
Yeah, I want it to be a boy. I'm liking that. Legacy mode, like Succession. I need another boy to keep the name going.
You need another girl.
No. Dealing with one that
should,
has
I
to
think
do
you should
it.
Start just saying, like, I'm going to be happy with what come. Just so you might could put, you know what I'm saying?
I'm going to be hurt.
It's too late.
It's all right. Yeah, I'm committed. Like,
it's already
gonna
out
be,
there. The bad juju's already gonna, out
I just
there.
Felt him kick for the first time this weekend.
He was like, oh, that's a boy kick.
Yeah, that's what I said.
I know a boy when I feel
boy.
It.
Yeah.
I can't no girl kick that hard.
Yeah.
This cat sexist.
No. I'm going to be happy regardless, but I hope it's a boy, man.
That's dope, man.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
This is our last hoorah. I want it to be a boy. Whatever it is, I don't mind, but I hope it's a boy. Girls are.
What if it's twins?
It's not twins.
It's
I've been at every doctor's appointment, well, most of them, and hey. I'm suing them if it's twins.
Oh, we didn't see that one back there.
Nah,
the little fella's hiding out.
That's crazy. I'm actually really excited, man. I'm really excited for this pregnancy. You know, when you have kids, like, when I had my son, we weren't ready. Mm. Like, mentally, I wasn't ready to be dad. You got to get ready. We wasn't ready financially, none of that.
Right.
You know what I mean? And now I feel like we married, we set, and we're having a kid. No pressure. Like,
yeah,
we just
dope.
Go on with the flow, but I'm
that's
excited.
Super dope.
And the in-laws are coming back.
This weekend?
No, remember how they are coming this weekend, but like, you know how they come in town for the, when she had the kids?
Oh, yeah.
So they come, pray for me.
Oh, yeah.
You got Grandma and Ma.
You got a rest haven on, you know, my
yeah,
street.
I'll pull up at your crib. Yeah,
because
yeah, you know, they just take over and just be wild.
Usher wants to do the Super Bowl.
Yes.
Shout out to Usher.
Oh, my God. That would be so dope.
I'm glad that he put it out there.
I'm here for Usher Super Bowl.
I'm here for Usher being a Super Bowl.
He'll definitely be creative. He'll be like entertaining.
It'll be entertaining.
Like,
man, it'll be entertaining.
He gonna do some shit.
If he was smart, he'd do that shit on skates.
It's gonna be a skate.
It's
team.
Gonna be some skates.
They're gonna build him a rink.
It's gonna be some skates.
If he do that shit
involved.
On skates at the Super Bowl,
it's gonna be some skates.
Because you know, people know that he do his show on skates, mm-hmm. but everybody yeah. don't know.
But he a beast.
And you know what I'm saying? I think that'll just be something that people would be like, whoa.
He does all his shows in skates?
He do
well,
skate
the
scenes every,
residency?
His residency. Yeah.
Really?
He do a skate,
yeah,
a skate segment
that.
Every time.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That's dope. Please make it happen. Chip, text Jay-Z.
I'm going to get on that.
You got to make that happen.
Please and thank you.
Yeah. I'll put this all in a group.
He got the song. He definitely got the songs to do it. He got the, if you.
The longevity.
You
mean, he got
Rihanna
the showmanship.
You can definitely let Usher do it.
Art.
I just want to hear Caught Up.
No, that's not true.
We listened to Usher all the way on the way back from the wedding, too.
I'm saying he's going to be able to dance and stuff. That's what I'm saying. Like,
okay.
He's going to do that.
Yeah.
Whatever that is.
All that. The Weeknd don't be dancing. And they have The Weeknd out there.
What y'all know about him?
Yeah.
Super.
You gotta perform that.
He will for sure.
I'm gonna let y'all know y'all gonna be very disappointed because got 15 minutes, if that.
Yeah, and you know he doing that the pop shit.
You
hell yeah.
Baby, let me love you, dad.
30 seconds of it, that's it.
You know
he
doing
he
that
doing
shit.
The whole song of that.
Man.
And, well, yeah, he going to do yeah for sure.
Oh, he better not.
Yeah.
We're going to be mad as fuck at the Super Bowl performance.
Nah, yeah, we'll get caught up. We'll get caught up in Bad Girl. That might be it.
Maybe.
And Caught Up still borderline. Caught Up, like.
Y'all don't think he doing no slower type?
Hell no.
Not just squeeze one.
Rihanna did some slower songs, didn't she?
What, a ballad?
Yeah, like a.
No, he could do.
8701.
Sam, he has to do. You Got It Bad or something.
That's what I was.
He got to do like some of that shit. Just right. At least the beginning.
I don't know.
He better.
Yeah,
he gonna
do
you
make
me
wanna.
But that's a beat.
We gonna need about 30 minutes at least.
I ain't never spin the Usher on the vinyl yet.
I'm about to listen to Usher on the way home.
Listen,
I was listening to Confessions. I didn't realize how many records I skipped either. It was some duds on Confessions too.
Oh, it for was. Sure. It was.
Yeah, it was.
But wasn't that like a super long album too?
Yeah.
Like 20 some songs.
My wife told me that back in the day she made up a dance routine, a throwback. We was in the car.
Tell your wife I got cash
she
money.
She probably still knows it too.
She was kind of doing it in the car. She like, oh yeah, this part right here I was doing the pimp walk. It's like, what? What?
Tell your wife I got cash money to see that.
Oh man.
Man.
Yeah, I'm so here for Usher.
Yeah, I'm here for it.
For the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Make it happen, Captain.
I will. I want to vent right quick.
All right, what's up?
So, you know, I'll be collecting vinyls.
Cue the music.
Oh, yeah.
That's sad. That's what I want to do. So, I'll be collecting vinyls. Mm-hmm. And I've been wanting this Wolf vinyl by Tyler, the Creator.
Okay.
Right? I've been searching every, not every day, but at least like twice a week for like 3 years now.
Okay.
Like I just was typing in. It's fucking good. I've been typing it in, searching for the album. The resale, he's not selling it no more, but the resale on it is like $400. And damn. I'm like, I'm no way in hell am I paying $400 for this album.
Ooh-wee.
So, not mind deep. You, I've been wanting this since I started really back to collecting vinyl. This is one of my favorite albums. I haven't been checking it. And 3 days ago, I go to check it. Like, all right, let me just do my normal Tyler, the Creator, Will vinyl search. From April 11th to April 13th, he restocked the 10-year anniversary Will vinyl for $100.
Wow.
Damn. Four disc it. Set.
And look, you slept it.
Look at God.
And I've never seen it. It's gone. That shit was gone. And I missed it. And it's probably never going to go on sale again.
Oh, no.
And I'm so mad.
Ba, ba, ba,
so.
Damn. I'm sorry, big dog.
Mara said bring it back. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm highly upset. I've been mad for days.
Yeah,
and I keep checking this website just to say, like, hey, maybe.
No.
Maybe.
No.
Maybe. Maybe put it on there. Maybe it's there. I did find it on StockX for $250. So.
Well, that's close enough.
Man.
Yeah, you know, we might pull that trigger. We'll see. We'll see. I really want it. It's pink. What do you say?
Brown.
$130 on StockX? Mm. I'll make sure it's right. Nelly and Ashanti.
I'm here for it.
They're back together?
Definitely. That walk and that handhold made me feel like I bought these tickets, we holding hands.
Come here, baby.
Yeah.
That's exactly.
And they
what
had
it
a show out there, like, hey, don't get too cute. Let's go. that's the vibe that I got.
For real.
You better check on your boy.
Big Irv.
Bitch, I'm on Big Irv.
He probably somewhere drunk.
At the wall.
Salty again.
Swinging out the air.
I knew it.
I don't know, man. Irv just.
Irv, what more do you want from me?
Irv, man.
Yeah,
salty.
Irv.
Salty.
He broke the bro code anyway with doing the interview. Like you.
Facts.
No, he did.
World players know, like, we don't do this, man.
He definitely.
I'm retired, but I'm just saying. Like, you know?
Yeah, they was at the fight together, too. You know what I'm saying? Then they did the
it's
show.
A big stage.
She was definitely grinding.
For sure.
I want to know what took the nigga so long, because she been looking fine as hell.
for every bad one.
For,
it wasn't him.
Know,
I think it was
a lot
her.
Of them out there.
It was probably her. Wasn't him, it was her.
It probably was.
It was
her.
Both of them. Like,
I mean, but
don't
he,
get it twisted. Like, a rich black man.
Was he married?
Can get somebody. He
no,
was
he
engaged.
He was with that chick.
Yeah, he was engaged.
He was
girl.
With Floyd's ex, which was.
Yeah, which is hilarious. Oh.
Hilarious.
But I wouldn't put that just on him. Like, he can have the pick of the litter, too.
Yeah.
I mean, that's fucking Nelly.
It's Nelly. Country grammar.
I just think it was her, though. Like, not on some selective stuff, on some, like,
Well, she was dating the French dude. Wasn't she engaged to him?
I don't know.
Was French, she?
He was from France. Rihanna. I thought Ashanti was. Mm. I could be wrong.
I thought Ashanti was gay.
Oh, my God. Stop. Man,
she was single for so long.
You couldn't have thought that.
I don't mean. Come on, man.
You would have thought hoe before gay.
Yeah, that's what I thought. She's just having her way out here.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, I didn't think she was doing that. I just thought she was. Yeah. Having her pick of the litter.
Make sure we got everything before we get out of here. Oh, that scared me. Oh, y'all got anything
else?
She
dated James Harden?
I didn't know that.
Well, James, you know, he dated Trina. He,
Deshaun Jackson.
James Harden was out here, like.
Flo Rida.
God damn, I didn't know she dated Flo Rida. When was that?
It don't say the year.
Boots with the birds. Remember they trying to say Flo Rida took Nelly album? Remember that?
I believe that.
Yeah.
I believe that.
Y'all got anything else before we get out of here? I'm hungry. Go ahead.
I'm good.
Shout out to P. Rich, man. Just tied the knot. We had a
Shout
great
out
time.
To P.
Shout out to P, man.
If all minds are clear.
I'm going to the hall, Mom.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations, yeah. Chip.
Did we say that on the show?
Not yet.
Nah. It's
okay. Oh, it's okay. Yes, we do want to give a...
That's dope.
Big congratulations to Charles Walter Colvin.
Wow.
Don't do that. I mean, that's a great lineup.
It is.
Don't
say my name.
It's out there.
Being inducted into Wilson Hall of Fame. That's a super, 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 super big honor.
That is so dope.
Appreciate it.
And... What makes yours even more of an honor, and it doesn't take away from nobody, you know what I'm saying, that got in like this, but you didn't get in sports.
Nah.
And normally when somebody, you know, it's a sport.
I told my wife, though, I'm turning in my football picture for her.
I wouldn't do that.
Just leave that one.
Just let it go. I didn't tag you when somebody said you was the best long snapper in the city. Somebody put that on.
I mean, I was legit. They could have threw me up there.
They did.
Did they?
Yeah,
somebody said
you and Sprague made.
Nah, I don't think Sprague played high school football, but
I think it was Dez actually.
That was nice.
But no, for you to get in. Without it being sports, and,
yeah,
you know, I know what you do,
yeah,
and how you do it, and everything that you do. So
appreciate it.
Big ups to you. You're the only nigga I know.
Okay.
Yeah.
In the Hall of Fame.
Okay.
That's fire.
Appreciate it, man. I appreciate that.
I'm pulled over like. My nigga in the Hall of Fame, right?
Okay.
Yeah, y'all know Chip. Like, you know. That's my dog. When I show my license, I'm going to show our picture together. Like, man, oh, you know him too? Crazy, you know him? Man, that's my man. Stupid.
I was just having a fool, man.
I be with seeing them all the time. H-Bean, I know everybody.
What's the dog's name? Grace.
That's your dog name?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Grayson.
I thought that was your dog.
Yeah, Grayson. I thought you said Grace. I was like, wait, I thought you had a boy. But no, big ups to that. Let's say the movie podcast, talking about movies. And the sports podcast, talking about sports. And the music podcast, talking about music. Saying the gossip podcast, talking about gossip. Came out the pod.
Yeah.
She can't knock the...
Should go out on Lil Sosa, man.
Episode 152.
Yeah.
Powered by LVA Studios. And we out.